فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Today's benefit, inshallah ta'ala, is going to be from the book by al-Shaykh Abdul Rahman ibn Nasir al-Si'di rahimahullah. He has a book called Al-Wasail al-Mufidah lil-Hayat al-Sa'idah. Al-Wasail al-Mufidah lil-Hayat al-Sa'idah means that are beneficial for a good life. So the Shaykh rahimahullah is talking about ways that a person can have a good life. In the beginning of his book, the Shaykh says the following. And so inshallah ta'ala, this quote of his and statement of his, inshallah ta'ala, is going to be the benefit of today. He says, وأعظم الأسباب لذلك وأصلها وأسها هو الإيمان والعمل الصالح. قال الله تعالى من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون. الشيخ رحمه الله, he says, one of the greatest ways and means, rather the foundation in which a person can gain a good life. If you want to live a good life, the foundation for it and the greatest way to achieve it is al-Iman, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to believe in the angels, to believe in the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He sent, to believe in the messengers that were sent, to believe in the Day of Judgment, to believe in that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has destined for you, the good and the evil of it. And it is also to come with righteous actions. And the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, based on the statement of Allah, من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن. Anyone who comes with righteous actions, whether it's a male or a female, Allah says, فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. We're going to give them a good life. وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ. And Allah says, we will reward them. أَجْرَهُمْ, with their good actions. بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, on the greatest actions and the greatest things that they did. Shaykh says here, فأخبر تعالى ووعد من جمع بين الإيمان والعمل الصالح بالحياة الطيبة في هذه الدار وبالجزاء الحسن في هذه الدار وفي هذا وفي دار القرار. The Shaykh said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has informed us in this verse, and He has promised us, for the person who combines between Iman and righteous actions, the person who brings together Iman, the six pillars and the six articles of Iman, and تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. And the second one is righteous actions. If you bring those two together, بالحياة الطيبة, Allah is going to give you a good life in this world. في هذه الدار, in this world. وبالجزاء الحسن في هذه الدار وفي دار القرار. And that Allah is going to reward you with good in this world and also in the hereafter. By having what? Iman, the six articles of Iman, and having righteous actions. Then the Shaykh goes on to say, وسبب ذلك واضح فإن المؤمنين بالله الإيمان الصحيح. This is clear. For verily the one who believes in Allah, a true belief. Al-Muthmir lil-amal al-Salih. Then this belief It then produces righteous actions on the person's limbs. المصلح للقلوب والأخلاق. That rectifies and corrects your heart and your manners. The iman here, what does it do, brothers and sisters? It produces righteous actions on the limbs. That's what it will do. If a person has a true iman, it will start to produce on their limbs righteous actions. And what it will also do is the person's heart and their manners will also be in accordance to how Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves and is pleased with in this world and the hereafter. These people who have their righteous actions and they also have an iman, the Shaykh says, ma'ahum usul, and they truly have a foundation. Wa ususun, they have usul, foundation, fundamental foundations. يتلقون بها جميع ما يرد عليهم من أسباب السرور والابتهاج وأسباب القلق والهم والحزن. This strong foundation of theirs, which is righteous actions and correct iman, it allows them to face every matter in which they encounter in their lives, whether that matter is a joyful matter, a happy day, they will deal with it in the correct way. وَأَسْبَابُ الْقَلَقِ, and if hardship, depression, stress comes their way, وَالْهَمِّ وَالْأَحْزَانِ, they also have strong foundation in how they should deal with it. Their iman is intact. They have righteous actions. So the foundation which they have built themselves allows them to deal with every situation that comes their ways. And the situation, my brothers and sisters, that comes our ways is one of two. It is either we are happy and we're excited and we're enjoying ourselves, or we're in a position and a time where we're depressed and we're stressed. And the believer who has the righteous, who has the correct iman, and who has the righteous actions will deal with those two correctly. And the evidence for that is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which Imam al-Muslim rahimahullah narrated in his sahih min hadith al-Suhayb radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, where the Prophet said, he said, ajaban li amri al-mu'min, amazement is the affairs of the believer. In amrahu kulluhu khayr, all of these affairs are good. In asabathu sarra shakara fa kana khayran lahu, if good comes his way, he deals with it in what way? He comes with gratitude. He comes with gratitude, shukr. Wa in asabathu darra, when hardship comes his way, when pain and suffering comes his way, he deals with it with what? Sabr, patience. فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ, all of the affairs of the believer is good for him. Because from the good that he's going through, he deals with it with gratitude. The hardship that comes, he deals with it with patience. وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ, and no one has this except the believer. Which his whole life is between gratitude and patience. How has he gained that, my brothers and sisters? He has gained it based on the ayah, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَّرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٍ فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. They had correct iman, and they came with righteous actions, and so whatever situation they were in, they dealt with it the way they needed to deal with it, because of the strong foundation in which they had intact before the occurrence of this situation. And this is the benefit I wanted to share with you today. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.